Fantasy Player of the Week, but we had to.
Hello, everyone. I'm RecV5.
And I'm Sandman99.
And we're back with our Madden 2005 Lifers franchise, Season 2.
Yes, and we're going into Week 16. And we are undefeated at 14-0. And we appear to be on a collision course with the Cincinnati Tigers.
Yes, that's right. They're also 14-0.
They are the only other undefeated team in the league, but they are in the AFC, so we'd have to make it to the Super Bowl in order to play them.
Yep.
But it seems likely that they will go undefeated, and it also seems likely that we will as well. Because our next game is against the Seattle Pigeons. And we have historically had their number.
Yeah, well, it's because they suck.
Well, I was going to be more diplomatic about it than that, but...
Well, the diplomatic way of saying they suck is to say it, they suck.
Yeah. But anyway... The Seattle Pigeons have never beaten us. And I don't think we've ever played them where we haven't completely shellacked them by 4 touchdowns or more.
Yeah.
So, pretty sure we're going to be 15-0 after this week.
Probably.
And I'm not sure who we finish up the season against, but I think that we get... a couple of easier games at the end of the season after a fairly tough stretch where we played a very determined New York Knights team, and then we had games against the Zombies and the Desperados, and then we played a fairly tough defense in the Arizona Stingers before we finally broke out and blew out the Swamp Rats 38-13 last week. So, anyway, here we go. And looks like they're all offense all the time.
Well, whenever they ever anything different.
Yeah. Although they're slightly below middle of the pack defensively for points allowed. We're number one.
Yep.
We're only allowing 11 points per game, which is pretty good, actually.
Good.
Well, it's good enough for first in the league, so...
Well, hopefully it'll be good enough for Super Bowl.
Yeah. Yeah, hopefully we don't have a big defensive letdown in the playoffs like we had last season. Welcome to this NFC West matchup as the home team. But I guess we need to work on getting tuned up over the next couple of weeks. I think one guy there is a lot taller than the other.
You think?
Boy, you talk about a quarterback who can light up the scoreboard. This guy can do it all. And the scary thing is, he's getting better with each
game. Isn't this the guy that we got a picture of flat on his back in the thumbnail for this season?
I think so, maybe.
I think so, yeah.
Yeah.
The Pigeons quarterback, because we sacked him a lot the first time we played him.
Well, I'm expecting good things from you then, because, you know, they suck.
Well, you know what? I'm making some small adjustments, too. In the larger sets, I'm leaving Lamar Holt in as defensive end. But in the nickel packages, I'm going to try and give Greg May some playing time.
All right.
Because Greg May... has the potential to become a special player. Both teams eager to get today. He's second in the league in sacks, even though he's only actually started 3 games. So I guess we need to choose our audibles.
Yep.
All right, we better choose our audibles here. Okay. Well, that's me.
All right, let's see what I can set up here.
Yes, I've introduced a little more 4-3 into the defensive playbook, too.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, which is why I had some four-man line audibles there.
Although I should introduce some different things into the playbook. So I haven't modified the playbook in a while now.
Well, I think, though, that you've just about got things where you want them.
Yeah, well, it's just the long passing attack I want to work on.
Should be a return here.
Well, you just have to throw that play action bomb to Quincy White down the middle of the field.
Ha!
The offense down to the field for the first
when
time.
It seldom works.
Well, yeah, but when it works, boy, it worked. It was an instant touchdown. Oop. There we go. We got it together now.
First and 10. The quarterback lines
that's
up
the thing about it, though, too,
United.
Is the reason why that worked is because that linebacker didn't bite on the play fake.
Closing in.
Instead, he chose to cover Quincy White, which he can't do.
Yeah, two-ton truck pulling a trailer.
All right. You want to be that way about it.
Now they're going to start off throwing over the middle.
Yep.
Now look at this. They're coming out in I formation, three wide receivers already.
Yeah, that was what they ran on the first play, too.
Smith.
Oh.
Diving back at the 49-yard line.
Okay.
They're trying to spread you out and get something big on you.
Yeah, they sure are. They're trying to create that instant big play. Yeah.
All right, Jill, thank you for the update. Dropping back to pass on first down. Throwing. And this pass is completed.
Well, we got a shot on him that time.
Second and six coming up here.
You know what? That is just such crap. Well, that's the last score they get this game.
Well, they're going to be running the ball a lot more anyways.
Well, we're going to be playing five-man line for the rest of the game now. There's going to be no runs up the middle going forward.
The kick is up.
I hate it when they do that. Because that's just, there's nothing you can do to prevent that. You can play your safeties back deep, and they seem to manage to get a couple of offensive linemen down the field and block those safeties out. And you know what? I think that's absolute nonsense, too, because a quick, agile safety should be able to avoid a big, clumsy offensive lineman in the open field. Right? It shouldn't even be possible for that kind of blocking scenario to actually work.
Well, to be fair, it wouldn't actually end up working out that way anyway, because the lineman would run into a linebacker before he ever got down to the safety.
Yeah, but the thing is, even so, in the open field, I'm pretty sure that a professional athlete who is a safety in the NFL would be able to outrun and outmaneuver an offensive line, any offensive line.
Well, there was that one offensive lineman you're watching commenting on the latest Madden that came out.
I know, but
and he's
what?
Like he was looking at his speed rating, and it was like 40 something, and he's like, they know I can run a 4.440, right?
I know, but it's not just about speed.
Now, what am I doing?
I mean, there's also agility. The ability to stop and change directions, you know, like that kind of stuff, right?
Yeah, yeah.
You want someone there to tell you to watch out.
And what I'm saying is that a 200-pound safety can probably avoid physical contact with a 300-pound offensive lineman in the open field.
The defense lines up in the
at least not without that lineman taking some kind of penalty in order to keep up to him. Just saying.
Hmm.
Slings it to the outside. Short pass completed to the wide receiver.
Yeah.
Out of bounds at the 37.
We'll just do that.
You're in a hole here on third down. And they come through with this perfect play that gets him a first and keeps the drive going.
I know, it stings a little bit. I take a lot of pride in my defense's performance. And it really drives me nuts when something like that happens.
Yeah.
39-yard line. So a pickup of maybe
especially because it doesn't matter what kind of defensive formation you put out there, when they roll the dice and it comes up instant touchdown, it doesn't matter what defensive formation, what kind of coverage, what kind of rush assignments you have, it's a touchdown.
Nigel, thank you for the update.
Wow, that was awful blocking from number 74 there.
Yeah, he got out there, but he didn't turn around and block that linebacker like he should have. Maybe he would have if you'd have motioned the wide receiver over to get on top of the corner there. Because he looked like he turned to the outside like he thought he wanted to block the corner instead.
Yeah, he had some indecision there.
Yeah.
Really, he should just block the nearest man.
Well, it's just like John says, right? You try and block everybody and you end up blocking nobody, right?
That's right.
Yeah.
Moves in motion. Dropping back. Looking downfield.
Oh, wow. I thought you were in trouble there, but you managed to find someone.
Yeah, well, you know, maybe that linebacker should have been a little more awake, too. It did kind of go over his head.
Yep. Well, it's nice to see that some of this nonsense isn't all just one way. That's the way to spread that ball around.
So they need about three here. Calling an audible. Number six with a man in motion.
Yeah. See, you use that right tight end as if he's a fullback, right?
Yeah, pretty much.
Just send him through that gap and have him block that linebacker, and then you can just barge straight ahead.
Looks like he's calling an audible. Number six sends a man in motion.
Had to snap that one a little earlier.
Yeah, you ran out of time there.
Yeah. Although it looked like somebody lost their block there anyways, it wouldn't have mattered.
Well, it can happen sometimes, though, if you run the same play twice in a row, right?
Yeah, well, if they're spread way the hell out wide, though, why would I not try to dive
up the middle
again?
I would just run this to the right and see if you have anything there, because the way they're lined up, you got nobody to contain you wide, right?
Yeah. Well, safety will get me about 5 yards down the field.
Yeah, and they got the line shifted to the other side, and, you know, like, basically it's just the safety between you and the big game, right?
Come on. What is this spot? Is that home field disadvantage
yeah,
again?
Yeah, really. Boy, oh boy, that was a terrible spot.
He did most of his damage after he broke free. Let me tell you, this defense is going to have to adjust their pursuit.
That's going
to
be another one of those ones where the center's hand is almost touching the goal line, eh?
I actually don't know if I can motion that tight end out there to match up against that corner.
It showed an arrow out to the right.
Well, I won't have to worry about it this time.
Yeah, because he's pulled in now.
Tosses it out to the right. Hand it off to the back. He gets the ball into the end zone.
You got no corner out wide there, and you have a fast guy in the backfield. They're not going to be able to stop you. Is that Anderson running that?
Yeah, well, I think Gaines got subbed out because he got tired.
Yeah, well, that's good. No, I was asking because Anderson got shaken up on the opening kickoff return, right?
Yeah, he's back now. He had, like, a whatever bursitis or something or other. Who knows? He's kind of soft, unlike Gaines. That's not the first time this season he's had that kind of thing happen.
Well, I was just a little concerned because he is our kick returner, right?
Yeah, without him, Houston would have to do it.
Boy, you gonna give up a kickoff for a touchdown or what?
Hey, he spun me, man. Nobody does that. They usually just run right into your arms.
First and ten. The quarterback lines up with two backs behind him. Throwing on first down. Almost got it. Almost a big turnover.
One thing remains constant. No matter what kind of quarterback you are, rushing your throws is going to end up in incompletion or worse.
There he goes again.
Yep, he's trying.
4 yard gain on the play.
But we're not going to give him anything.
5 yards to go. The visiting team line up with two backs behind the quarterback.
Brings him down. Running on third down and five. Hey.
Yep.
Very solid defensive effort to force the three and out. Here's the kick. The officials are trying.
Well,
to
not much I could do on that.
So they have first and ten here.
Wow.
Going to the air on first down. Gets the pass off.
And he runs over a guy.
Yeah, and then the next guy that tackled him pushes him over the first down line.
Johnny had a big speed advantage.
Yeah, he's one of those guys who's a good straight line runner, so you can't let him get behind you. If you do, then there aren't going to be too many guys who are going to be able to run and catch.
Well, I mean, when you come out in three wide receivers and they line up like that, like, come on.
Houston, in motion. He hands it off.
Ooh. Right. Good thing you're fast there because that end beat his man, eh?
Yep.
Inside the 42 to convert.
Okay. I guess they didn't like that.
He's looking. Rolls left with the pass.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. I didn't even see that guy.
Well, he was running sideways, trying to run out to the flat, I think, and then he just turned around and caught that. I'm like, oh, well, he's running sideways. I'll throw it behind him. And no, he just, like, turned right around and just caught that.
Yeah, I totally didn't even see him.
Ball at midfield.
I don't know. I was hoping to fire it behind him.
Carpenter, the man in motion.
Yeah, that coverage didn't turn out how I thought it would at all.
We'll feel that one tomorrow.
Yeah, with how hard he just got hit, he's not going to be able to hold on to the ball.
They have to get the ball inside the 42 to convert. They give it to the halfback. Number 43 takes him down at the 42. So that play goes for about six.
Under a yard to go.
The visiting team line up with two backs behind the quarterback. They'll go to the run once again. He's brought down.
Five-man line.
Smith didn't get any help from his offensive line.
It was just about impossible to run when you have guys in the backfield just as soon as you snap the ball.
Hartley will try to pin
the monster. Will always be in my playbook.
Here's the punt.
And this will be at least it didn't take a Louisiana bounce.
Yeah.
So we have first and 10 here.
These guys are putting maybe they are 7-7. Maybe they're going to try and put on a late season charge, eh? Try and get a wild card spot or something.
Passing right.
Ooh, boy, that was close play, but.
Big hit on the ball carry.
When you talk about getting unloaded on, that's what happened here.
He just that was a 24-yard gain.
Nice read, finding the receiver who was in single coverage.
That's what happens when they miss their tackle.
Yep.
We reach the end of the first quarter, and the teams have switched sides, and we'll start the second quarter. It's first and 10.
Well, it looks like you're going to get a steady diet of this now.
Throw, no completion there. Big drop on that play, John.
He did a nice job of getting in position and giving the quarterback.
I guess all
target.
That tape on his fingers didn't help, control. Eh? It's not grip tape.
Yeah, really, what he needs on his fingers is to stick them.
Looks like he's calling an audible. Calling an audible. Hudson moves in motion.
Not enough time.
Hands it off to the back. Simeon makes the tackle.
Never enough time, because you have to wait for everybody to sumo in place.
Yep, you got to wait for everybody to stop moving.
And be able to make the big run in the second half.
The defense lines up in the nickel.
All I can say is, goddamn, that's annoying.
Yep, it is.
Throwing. Perfect throw. The 40 dives and makes the tackle. Number 6, zipped that ball to his receiver.
With an arm like that, there isn't a pass that he can't make.
First and 10. On the call.
Well, that was very cooperative of them.
The tackle at the 28. They went with the running play.
You never know when you're going to find some room and break loose into the secondary.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah.
I threw that behind Hudson because I'd already pressed the button. I'm like, oh, shit, I shouldn't throw it there. There's a coverage guy dropping back there. So I, like, threw it behind him.
That's okay. It still worked. He made the adjustment and caught the ball.
Yeah, that was like a split-second decision. If the corner had been more sharp, he would have been able to cut that off.
Yeah, well, luckily they don't have a very good defense.
Looks like he's calling an audible. First down with the pass. And this pass
in fact, I'm kind of shocked that you threw an interception against these guys, actually.
Well, it was totally covered. The play was totally covered, and I was looking for an open guy. And then I saw that linebacker running across the formation, and he ran past Gaines. So I'm like, okay, well, he's past Gaines, and he's running in the opposite direction. I'll throw it behind him and get it to Gaines, and maybe he'll be able to catch it. And no, he just made, like, this instant turnaround. In typical Madden fashion.
Robert. Smith,
you know how it goes.
Yeah, I know how it goes.
We're going to, keep
to tell you the truth, I didn't even see that guy. I totally didn't see him. I was not even having to scan for receivers or anything like that. I just plain didn't see him out there. He was invisible.
Looking to run it here.
Now this is exactly how to get the ball in the end zone. Just get in behind the center and guard and keep pushing and pushing until they're putting up 6 points on the board.
There you go. Classic fullback.
Yep. Well, you know what I found is that that style of offense, even in other formations where you do similar things, seems to work even when nothing else does. You just pound it straight at them and make your 2 yards or your 3 yards or whatever.
Well, it's like John says, right? You go to your fullback and you say, can you get me the yard? And he says, I'll get you a yard. And what if I need 2 yards? He says, I'll get you a yard.
Nice kick and returnable. From the 9 yard line. They forced a 3 and out on the last series.
Oh, look at this. They're going to double tight end formation now.
So they have first and 10 here. The quarterback gets set with only one back behind him.
Crunch.
He was really hit hard on that play.
Yeah, you talk about your depleter. That's what happened there. He unloaded and he got a depleter.
It's solid run there, and that's exactly what they will
be. People getting all up, all slow back there. It makes you skip a beat.
Average 4 to 5 yards a carry.
Wondering if somebody got hurt again.
Production that every coach is looking for. But there are a lot of things that go into successful running it. You got to have good play calling, good blocking up front.
Wow.
Can take advantage when he sees the open.
Not sure what happened there. Was he trying to throw that to a guy who was not actually a wide receiver or what?
I don't know. But he didn't catch it.
They're making some changes up front. Franks moves in motion.
Could have just been lucky, too.
Yeah.
That happens every now and then.
Gets rid of it. The pass ball's incomplete.
See, it's deceiving because on that particular coverage, I have a guy playing the flat on both sides, too.
Yep.
And, so he goes over there and helps out the guy covering in man coverage there.
Here's the kick. From the 31. He didn't have much to work with, but still got away a decent return. So they have first and 10 here.
Wow.
Directing traffic.
That's a lot of guys on the line there.
He's looking, throws it, he hits his receiver.
Well, they didn't cover him.
Yeah. Well, he's not exactly known to be a receiving threat, though, right? Maybe they don't cover him because they figure he's going to drop it.
The defense is going to be pushing right in your face on third down. So a shorter drop and a quick throw will usually beat that if you don't need a lot of yardage.
See, it's a good idea to do that sometimes.
That's because they're continuing their effort to establish a run game here in the first half.
Calling an audible. With the throw.
No, he's going to pull him down by the collar now to make sure he doesn't get away from him.
Yeah. Well, Hudson's actually racked up a few catches in this game already.
Get it, get it, get it. Come on.
Well, that'll happen when you don't cover him the way you should.
Looks like he's changing the play. Feeds it off. Simeon with the stop at the 33. They went back to the run on that play.
That just goes to show you that the coach trusts the guy to hang on to the ball.
Looks like he's calling an audible.
Oh, shit.
Goes with a short pass.
I totally misread
that
coverage.
Third down, upcoming after the incomplete pass.
I saw the guys in the linebackers didn't behave the way I thought they were going to. I was going to be like, oh, well, maybe the... But I think actually they were running something like weird, like an engage eight or something. I think they were blitzing.
Yeah, they were sending extra people.
Sixth play of this drive.
It's probably just as well. I don't think he would have even had time to throw a slant there because they were really coming after you there.
Oh, this could be interesting. And it gives your offense a
I'm not throwing it to Houston. The safety's deep.
Could have thrown it to... I'd challenge that for sure. Because I think he's down.
Good play by the defense to recover the... So the coach throws the red flag, letting the referee know he wants him to look this one over. So what we're looking for here is whether one of his knees hit the ground.
Yeah, knees on the ground first, right?
Yep.
Like his whole shin was horizontal on the ground before the ball came out. He still has the ball, His ass is on the ground, and then the ball comes out. That's a bad call. It's in the game. At least once every game, it's in the game.
Is it really that frequent?
Yes, it is.
You've been keeping track of the conspiracy.
Well, no, it's just the way it is, right? They built it into a game, and pretty well every game I have ever been involved in or played, there has been a fumble that had to be overturned. Like, they never call it right.
Calling an audible now. In motion. Hands it off.
Well, okay.
Yeah, Mr. 99 there, he beat a guy and then he beat another guy and then...
With an aggressive defense like this,
sometimes you just can't win.
Yeah, I think the right side of the offensive line is a little weaker than the left side too, right? They're not as good at run blocking or pass blocking for that matter.
Pressure.
Just like that, see? That number 93 there, he just ran right around the tackle.
See, I would have thrown that, though, if it had actually let me throw it there, but instead I ended up getting stuck in the tackle break animation so that they could make me lose a bunch of yards.
Yeah. No, there wasn't anything you could do about it because the right tackle did not block his man, right? He didn't even shuffle sideways to try and keep up with him. And they don't really have especially good defensive linemen on this team. That's just how bad that left tackle is, right?
Dropping back.
He did it again, too.
Gets rid of it. This pass is incomplete.
Great. Well, I guess you'll have to try a field goal.
This is a team that likes to take shots downfield when they see an opportunity. Passing downfield will open up the running game.
This is really too bad.
Even if you well, pass, that second down play there where you got sacked, I mean, that's...
49-yarder.
That left tackle did an absolutely terrible job of actually
well, it's not just
the
left tackle. That like
or
getting
right
in
tackle,
that
sorry.
That animation where you tackle break a sack.
Yeah.
That's like the worst thing that can happen to you because then you're all fucked up and then you're also going to get pushed backwards and you're also going to lose extra yardage because by the time you get through the tackle break off the sack, there's nobody to throw it to.
First and 10.
Really, I'd rather just get hit and have the ball go into the dirt.
They'll go from the I formation. going to the air on first down with the throw.
Oh, man.
If only.
Oh, wow.
And you'll see that kind of thing out of these guys a lot. They're big and they're strong and they're fast. Opposing offensive line sure have their hands full when they get out in this field.
Lewis pulls him down at the 39. Just a short pickup on that play, John.
They're just trying to get this run established. When you get it going in the ground, it really opens things up for the other options you have on offense.
And they'll face a long third down here. The home team doesn't want a long pass over anybody's head here, so they back up the secondary. Gets rid of it. Short swing pass.
Well, don't worry, because they're going to throw it to the flats.
Yep. At the 41-yard line.
Well, basically, I was just playing two man-to-man on the outside, three deep zone.
So yeah,
two short guys in the middle, and then flats.
Here's the punt. He's waving for the fair catch.
Because I was trying to make him throw the short pass or the flat pass, right?
Yep.
First and 10. Houston, the motion man. White. Penalty marker down in the field.
Uh-oh.
He wasn't about to let the
runner. Oh, they're declining.
Watch the center of his body and ran. He hit him solidly. Just like you're supposed to do in a one-on-one situation.
I didn't even read what that penalty was. I just declined because you said decline.
Their left outside linebacker jumped offside.
Ah.
But the result of the play was better than the penalty, so.
Hudson moves in motion. Again, he'll get the call.
Yeah, that didn't stand a chance.
For negative yardage. He records his third tackle of the game. Second and long. The visiting team come out in a nickel package. Hand it off to the back. Fakes the handle with the throw.
Oh!
Complete. Dixon comes up to knock that ball out of the receiver's hands before he was able to get control of it.
Yeah, we see a lot of footballs popping up when he makes contact. His instincts know when to deliver the hit and how to do it.
They come out in a dime package. Number six with a man in motion. Drops back. He's looking. Throws
yeah,
it out
no.
Over to the left.
It's not gonna go.
Pass the ball is incomplete. Coming. We'll go back to accept this punt. Here's the kick. From the 23.
Wow, that guy was enthusiastic.
He's just doing his job.
Yep.
Almost at the 2-minute mark now.
Right when the coach goes out there, he doesn't say, okay, we need you to make sure that you wrap him up and prevent him from getting any further than he needs to. No, the coach goes, you see that guy out there? I want you to kill that guy. That's what he says. I want you to take his head off and bring it back to me.
2-minute warning coming up. The corners are backing off. Using split back. Carpenter, the motion man. pressure coming. Throws it. Perfect throw.
Oh, come on. Oh, boy.
At the 47-yard line.
That's pretty cheaty. I don't know.
Almost at the 2-minute mark now. The visiting team line up with two backs behind the quarterback.
Yeah. That was the safety playing the flat zone, eh?
Yep.
Migrating across the field. I like to do that.
Force a quarterback to get rid of it before he's ready. And when he's rushing his throws out there, bad things are going to happen to this offense.
Looks like he's calling an audible.
You know, if I had the sense, I would have put Quincy White on a streak here.
Yep. He'll feel that one. Actually, you should be looking for opportunities like that, especially because these guys are playing guys up close to the line. And he's fast enough that I think he can outrun anybody on their team.
Houston in motion. Calling an audible. He sees something in the defense.
Oh, come on, number 74. You have to block a defensive tackle. You just have to block that guy.
They're just relentless when the offense decides to run the ball. They break down.
Look for that chance.
The offense doesn't work if he doesn't block that guy.
No. Well, that happens quite a bit, though, with our team, unfortunately.
Number 6 sends a man in motion.
You have to resort to trickery.
Dropping back, flings it to the outside. He has room. The 40.
Whoa, look at that. Runs through a tackle. Wow, you almost broke that for a touchdown.
Yeah, if I'd been a little bit quicker to step on the gas there, I might have.
Well, that was a pretty nice gain anyway.
First and 10.
That's probably just about the longest play of the day.
It's a two possession game if they get into the end zone.
Yeah, I like that.
Just inside the 20.
What?
Yeah, seriously, move him away now. Like, move him across the formation.
Another run. Ooh, that one will leave a mark.
Well, I had to kind of turn that up in a way I didn't want to in order to get across the line of scrimmage.
Well, at least your guard blocked that guy, though, and gave you a chance to get across the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, most of the time he doesn't even bother to block that guy.
But, like, anytime I have an opportunity to have nobody out wide on one side, I try to run to that side. I look for that opportunity.
Gets the pass off. He's inside the 10.
Oh, you almost made it in there again.
Picking up the first in the process.
That's a case of your receiver knowing where the marker is and the quarterback delivering the pass quickly.
Hand it off to the fullback. So he takes it the rest of the way for the touchdown.
He was like a locomotive with a full head of steam.
They'll line up for the extra point. The kick is up. The extra point attempt is good. The home team.
Well, we're on pace for 42 points.
Well, that's good.
From the 10. Defense forced the interception the last time this offense had the ball. And they'll be looking to do the same thing here. It's first and 10. Backing off. Only one man back. Pass successfully here on first down. Closing in, throws it. He hits his receiver. Seattle calls a timeout. They have two remaining. First and 10. Pressure on the move. The 40. Boston pulls him down at the 50. Nice job buying a little bit of time and then completing the pass.
Oh, they're on their last timeout. And they'll have to switch up to something different.
You really need to be careful on defense. He likes to open things up a little downfield, buying time by rolling out or bootlegging.
Only one man in the backfield. Dropping back to pass on first down.
Block fuckery going on there.
This pass is incomplete. He read the single coverage and went for it all on first down. Defensive line shifting around a bit. Only one man back. Drops back with the throw. And it's complete. Still running. Big hit on the ball carry.
Now when you talk about getting unloaded on, that's what happened here. He just got unloaded on.
And this should be the last play of the half. Loosening up the coverage on the outside.
Yeah, this will for sure be the last play of the half.
Yep.
They don't have time to kick a field goal or anything here.
With the pass. Incomplete pass. Going into halftime.
Yeah, I just played too deep and had the dime package out there, so those safeties were 20 yards off the line of scrimmage.
Yep.
Let's get back to the action.
And they were not going to be throwing a long pass for a touchdown.
Let's take a look at how both teams perform in the first half. Should be a return here. From the 7. To the 20, breaking free. The home team is looking to extend its advantage as they take
Anderson might get beat up a little, but that's his job.
Well, it's good to have a guy like that to return kicks.
And he just got level.
Yeah, well, everybody did what they were supposed to do that time.
Yep.
See, the plan does come together once in a while.
When people remember what blocking is.
Yeah.
Good play in the backfield.
I don't know about that.
Any news, Joe?
That just seems to happen far too often in this game.
Yeah.
And I mean, that halfback is shallower than in a normal formation.
Yeah, and you've got a very fast quarterback.
That was Jill Arrington with her sideline report.
It's just like they rolled the dice and it's like it came up sack.
Yep. Watch White on the left.
Dropping back. Surveys the field, throwing.
Because he's got that guy completely outclassed. That guy's a linebacker.
Well, thankfully, White caught that one, too. He doesn't also always have the most reliable hands in the world.
Yeah, but you know what? If he's going to be wide, wide open like that, you might as well. Look at he's got 87 yards receiving in this game so far. And if he can beat just about anybody that tries to cover him that badly, well, then you might as well throw it to him, right?
Trying to move the ball on the ground.
That was a nice run there.
Consistent and effective will help the offense dictate the pace of the game.
See, I saw that once in the first half, too, but you threw it to the other side to Hudson instead. Which is okay. I mean, he caught the pass and he made the yardage, but...
See, I thought you were telling me to throw it to Houston on that once in the first half. I didn't even clue in that White was
in there. I saw that mismatch there, right? When you moved White out of the backfield, a linebacker followed him. And, you know, like, no linebacker can cover that guy.
He sees nothing in the defense. Changing the play now. Clawson brings him down at the 22-yard line.
Yeah, just totally didn't even clue into me. In this one.
2 yards to go. Surveying the field. Gets rid of it. He'll bring him down at the 15-yard line. Good read finding the single coverage in the secondary.
Is that guy a wide receiver? Jackson?
Yeah. Well, he is now.
Yeah, well, I just noticed he had number 30, but I don't remember him being a running back on the team.
Yeah, he was a running back once. He never got any field time, though.
Yeah, well.
But he has okay catching, so he turned him into a wide receiver.
Yeah.
We'll get the ball again.
Yeah, this isn't going to work.
He's brought down behind the line for a short loss. Gaines couldn't pick up any blocking on that play.
The defense is always very aggressive.
Yeah, that safety came up
when
he was the extra man, right? Actually, the blocking on that play wasn't bad, but they just had one more guy than you had blockers.
So with the ball in the red zone, they have a very good chance of extending that lead. Gaines, the man in motion.
See that? They're sending a linebacker out to cover him again, except it's Gaines this time.
Drops back, looking downfield. Deep pass, looking for the end zone.
Oh, should have thrown it to Gaines again because he beat his man too.
Play by the defender. You know, he didn't look like he
However,
was there in
time. I'm not going to fault you for trying to throw that long pass because I do it a lot.
God,
but.
Number six with a man in motion.
Oh, I like the looks of this too. This is setting up nicely.
Dropping back, looking for a receiver. With
yep, that set up just about perfectly.
Knocked him out of bounds at the 1 yard line.
Watch it here. This is a great call on third down to keep this drive alive. They were in a tough spot here. This is a heck of a throw and catch.
Right, he was given way too much room to him over there. He's got 100 yards receiving in this game.
Number six sends a man in motion again with the run. That was an almost perfect run in that type of situation.
I have no idea if that helped anyone with anything at all.
I don't know. It didn't look to me like he really blocked anybody, but maybe he acted as a distraction.
The kicking team heads out onto the field. It's on its way, and the extra point is good. The home team really rolled.
Well, we're pulling ahead now.
Benson is just about ready to kick this one away.
Yeah, it's like I said, these guys suck.
Yeah.
Well, that kick was perfectly accurate.
Yeah, just not very deep. Good coverage, though.
Face an uphill battle as they begin this drive at the 21. Ball on their own 21. Backing off. They line up in the I formation. Hand off to the tailback. Number 43 makes the tackle at the 30-yard line.
He's looked pretty good so far. It's going to be up to the defensive coordinator to make some adjustments and find a way to slow him down.
About two to go. Only one man in the backfield. Drops back. Pressure coming with the throw. And the catch is made.
I had nobody on the flat on that side that time because I had to make an adjustment.
That way you had the flat on the other side?
Yeah, I had the flat on the other side, but the way that play was designed, the defensive end was supposed to be
going into the flat.
Smith couldn't find an opening and was brought down very quickly.
This line has to do a better job of holding up at the point of attack. He has a fast first step. He can explode through the hole. And he needs a line to create that little crease or cutback lane to break free.
Second and long coming up here.
Two tight ends over on the same side.
With only one back behind him. Gets the pass off. Pass ball's incomplete. So that one flutters incomplete.
He put too much touch on that one.
And this is the fifth play of this drive. They're making some changes up front. Smith, the lone back. Spence with a man in motion. Closing in.
Well, you got him there.
By Lewis. Lewis gets to him in a hurry.
And he really overpowered the blocker that time. He's a big, big, strong man.
Well, that time I didn't have any assignment for any of the defensive linemen except pass rush. So I could switch freely from one side to the other because on third down and 10, I don't think I have to worry too much about them running.
Here's the punt. From the 35-yard line.
Just run that guy over.
That one block to let him go the distance.
One or two more blocks would have sprung.
Or five or six. More blocks definitely would have sprung him.
I don't know if we'll ever get a punt return for a touchdown in this game.
At least we can get a punt return now.
I don't think I've ever actually seen a punt return or had a punt return for a touchdown.
Happy we can punt return.
Look who was 10 yards down the field blocking there. Number 79, eh? You see that?
Yep.
That's just not right. I really don't believe that that safety should have been successfully blocked by that offensive lineman who is a big clumsy guy compared to that safety.
Well, I guess the bullshit goes both ways.
Yeah, I guess so. I don't care how fast you can run in a straight line, right? You know, quickness and maneuverability are also factors.
This is a tough physical team that likes to run the ball in just about any situation. When you can run the ball consistently, it really wears down the interior line and helps to slow down those pass rushers.
With the pass, he finds his man. Terrell is the guy who's there to bring him down. At the 28, it's first and 10.
Aside from the fact that that guy is our rookie right tackle who happens to be the worst player on the offensive line, right?
His awareness was so poor he just didn't detect that linebacker.
Gets the pass off.
Come on, Gaines. You gotta catch those.
Fifth play of this drive.
Oh, look at that. They're sneaking a little extra help up there.
Not anymore, they're not.
Nope.
Throws it. He hits his receiver.
That's nice. You know, when you got Green on the outside like that, he gives you a block, and that helps you get a few extra yards. Eh?
That makes it hard for him to be sacked, and it gives the defenders less time to react.
See, that's what you get when you have tight ends playing wide receiver. Look at that. He's going out there again. Eh? He completely outclasses that corner out there. You got two tight ends blocking for you on that side, though. You just couldn't get it over the linebacker.
That's the thing. Yeah. That was a perfect opportunity.
That was lucky, though.
Play for his defense.
He dropped that.
Rather than an interception.
That was kind of badly thrown anyways. They're like, we're just going to give you this junky coverage where we play 11 guys on the line over and over again.
Yeah.
The receiver did a nice job of just hanging on to it.
Well, thing is, though,
in this part of the field, this is not as bad as if they were doing this at midfield, right? But it still looks like Hudson's got nobody covering him. Unless they're playing some kind of zone over there.
Gets the pass off, and he hits his target. That's three times in this drive they've been able to pick up a first down.
And the thing is, they'll be doing more than just picking up first down if this success continues. They're going to be picking up some points.
You know, I almost can't help but wonder if it's the play calling that I keep lining up in is influencing what they're choosing there, if they got somebody in the huddle with me.
I don't know. They definitely don't have the right thing called here, but it still worked.
Yeah, well, the last few times they stacked the line, I had this fullback dive called.
Yeah.
Because I've been calling this fullback dive, like, every play.
You got to keep moving forward. Plays that result in a loss or plays that don't get you anything will really hurt your shot at a touchdown.
Changing the play now.
I don't know. I don't think this is going to go anywhere either.
I wouldn't worry about it. Just run it at them anyway. You never know.
Carry.
You can push the pile for a couple yards, then.
Yeah, but that's worse than a phone. That kind of hit the
loose. At this point, you're guaranteed a point blank range field goal. And so even if you don't get in, I'm not too worried.
Consistent success on third down, which they've had, usually translates into a win.
Oh my god, that guy just came through totally untouched.
Yeah, luckily you were just barely fast enough to outrun him.
Yeah. Now that was that block fuckery thing there again, probably.
Well, that's the benefit of... No, that was where the tackle vacated.
Yeah, that's where my tackle vacated from.
Yeah, nobody traded up to pick that guy up.
Yeah.
And we go back to the game.
See, even when things work out right, they do things wrong.
Yeah, well, look on the bright side. At least that wasn't the 99 speed left end from the zombies or something.
God.
That was just a regular Joe from a regular Joe team, right?
The kick is up, and the extra point is good.
Yeah, you can't run against the zombies.
Took a number of plays, but with each one, they were able to make their way toward the end zone and ended the drive.
No,
with
not touchdown. Consistently. That's pretty tough.
Yeah, you basically have two plays in your playbook. Fullback dive and punt.
The key to that drive was how
no, actually, I throw a lot of wide receiver flat passes against them.
The offense would do another.
From the 12-yard line.
Oh, little excitement there. Yay! Oh, you're still on offense, yeah.
Yep.
So it's first and 10 following the fumble. Houston, the motion man. Aimed it off to the back.
Wow, that was a gaping hole that opened up there.
When you get hit like
good.
That, it's like having a bumblebee in your helmet. You just can't get rid of it.
Good game for the offense here in the second half.
This is one of those guys that seems to
it's too bad that tight end didn't actually lead you through that gaping hole because he might have been able to block the guy that tackled you.
Well, that's okay. I don't mind. As long as I was able to run the play and get the yards.
The visiting team come out in a nickel package. Hudson, the man in motion. Aimed off to the tailback. Open road to the end zone. He's at the 20. Right with the stop at the 13-yard line. And that game will get them a fresh set of downs.
He just exploded towards the
I wonder if White
time.
Is a candidate a for offensive run. Rookie. Because he's a rookie, isn't he?
Number 6.
Yep.
With a man in motion. Hands it off. Ooh, that one will leave a mark.
He got popped. I'll tell you one thing. He's going to feel that in the morning.
And a pickup of
he was ready for you that time.
Yeah, well, I went to cut to the inside there, but I think I could have beat him on the inside, but I was just a little too slow.
Oh, look at that. The Tigers won their 15-0.
Number six sends a man in motion. Tosses it out to the right. He'll get it again. And he's pushed out of bounds at the one. White picks up the first down. That's the second time on this drive he's been able to move the chains. Ball a half yard away.
Oh, you got 400 yards of total offense in this game.
Come on now.
He hands it off. So he puts his head down and punches it in for the score.
Well, I'm not actually sure if the ball crossed the line there, but okay.
Yeah, quick, kick the extra point in case they challenge it. No, it looks like the ball was on the goal line there. So you made it.
Benson comes in for the extra point. And it's on its way. And he tacks on the extra point. The home team continues to increase their lead. The home team.
Well, we're blowing them out now. You've doubled your halftime score already, and you still have a better part of a quarter to play yet.
I told you we were on pace.
They'll set up for the return. From the 7-yard line.
I hate that guy.
The visiting team will start this drive from the 20-yard line.
There you go. We got to draft a 99 speed defensive end so that we can put him on special teams.
Smith is the deep back. Spence sends a man in motion. Receives the handoff. Ooh, that one will leave a mark.
He got popped. I'll tell you one thing. He's going to feel that in the morning.
Gain of a handful. About six to go. Right, right.
Crap.
Throwing. This one falls.
Well, it's all good.
I tried, like I saw that the coverage was screwed up there, and I tried to change it.
But they snapped it like
instant. They didn't want to give me the chance.
Yep.
I guess.
The corners playing back. Only one man in the backfield. Dropping back. Pressure, steps up, throws it, and
wow, that was just a flat drop.
Yeah, I don't think he was going anywhere anyway, because I think that guy covering him was right in his back pocket.
Be able to hang on to.
I think it would be, if he'd have caught that, it would be like 4th and 1 right now.
Unable to get anything going on that series, they'll have to punt it away here. Here's the kick. And so the punt goes out of bounds. The running attack was very effective.
See, what did I say after that first fishy touchdown? That's the only one they're going to get, right?
I think the same thing to happen here again.
You're going to try and throw the bomb to Gaines, are you?
Gaines. They'll go with a play fake. Throws on the move. The pass ball's incomplete.
Yeah, I don't think you have any speed players on the field to throw that play to.
I don't need speed players. I was just looking to see if Gaines would make it through cleanly, and he didn't. And I'm just like, well, I guess this play's a bust. That's one of the plays I'd probably redraw, to be honest.
Well, you can't redraw the route to the halfback.
No, but I can redraw the rest of it.
Yeah, that was a nice run there.
Yeah, let me just get that 10-yard fullback dive after failing on the pass.
Nice job up front, holding their blocks and allowing him to get a good run for a first down.
Set, Delta, switch one. Come on now, what's the play?
Wow, you know, I don't think that linebacker can creep out any wider.
Nope, he's pretty much cheated out as far as he can get.
And yet somehow, in spite of how wide he was, Well, that tight end didn't pick him up.
There was no gap inside, like where you have that play drawn, you're supposed to avoid basically.
Well, it's not just that, right? So he's way out wide.
Yeah.
Look at who should block him.
Yep. Yeah, and he didn't. But still, though, like that play looks like it's designed to go in the gap between the guard and the center.
Yeah, it is.
Well.
Great fake with the pass.
There you go. Oh, look at this. He just turned that into a touchdown.
The 10. Number 6 has had a great year. He just connected on his 30th touchdown pass of the season.
Nice pass. Good job.
Benson comes in. That one can work sometimes.
Well, especially because you've been
dive,
a real run-heavy approach from that formation, and then suddenly you run that play action, then they pretty much bit on it. And then you got our best receiver matched up against their second best corner, which is a bit of a mismatch too, by the looks of it.
That guy is giving me trouble.
Yeah.
On the last series. So they have first and 10 here.
I don't know. Maybe we'll have to look for a possession receiver in the draft.
Franks moves in motion.
So they'll have about the speed that we need.
You've got a whole bunch of possession receivers.
Well, notice how I said possession receiver and not halfback. Right, my idea is a possession receiver will have more speed than a halfback.
He uses his hands well,
I see.
And he has those long arms. And that really helps him shed blockers.
Drops back with the throw. Picked off. And intercepted.
Hanks gets an interception.
I guess that was overthrown.
Yep.
Yeah.
Well, I had the pressure coming, though, right? He was going to get sacked.
And he was coming so fast.
And I was playing a 3-deep zone there, so Hanks was basically facing the ball the whole way, right?
This one is handed off. Wright takes him down at the 33. Gain of 3. 7 yards to go.
I'm just punishing them for that early touchdown.
Calling an audible now. Stay home, Mike. With the pass and the catch is made. Big hit on the ball carry.
And when you talk about getting unloaded on, that's what happened here. He just got unloaded on.
You can't draw it up any better than that. Textbook first down.
Set. Red. 16. Lucky. Lucky.
Hello, Roberts.
Passing on first down.
Yeah, pretty much. There's nobody covering him.
He'll feel that one tomorrow.
Yeah, with how hard he just got hit, he's lucky to be able to.
Dare I say, even Adam Parkman could have caught that pass.
No, Adam Parkman wouldn't catch that pass. Adam Parkman has one reception in his entire career, and he's been playing in the NFL for 3 seasons now.
Yeah. Of course, I don't throw it to him very often either.
He gets enough chances.
Throws it, and he can't find a way to keep possession. After the incomplete
pass, that's too bad. Too bad.
Play of this drive. So as they get set to try to convert, here's what both teams have done on third down.
Third down conversions is a keeper stat. When you convert on third down, you keep 3 things. You keep your drive going, you keep their defense on the field, and you keep your defense resting on the sideline.
It off.
Well, you managed to get the handoff away that time.
Yep.
And a first down.
If the defense keeps giving up runs like that for first down, they'll have to make some adjustments to slow this guy down.
Set.
Hut. This one is handed off. He's brought down behind the line for a short walk.
Well, I wasn't going to go anywhere there. I wasn't going to go outside. I wasn't going to go inside. I just wasn't going to go anywhere.
No.
If your defense can control the line of scrimmage, it makes running a ball to the middle of the formation very difficult. One thing you can try and do is some runs to the outside. Maybe a sweep or a toss play designed to loosen them up in the middle of the field.
They just audible to a quarter defense.
Yeah, they did.
On their goal line.
Well, because if you got no running back in the backfield, they know you're passing anyway, right? That should have been a touchdown, but
he dropped it.
Yar, sorry, wreck me 5X, but I couldn't close my hook around it.
He's having an off game.
Yeah.
Eighth play of this drive.
Maybe it's a depth perception problem with that patch over one eye or something.
Calling an audible.
Red, 58. Cowboy.
Under pressure, looking for an option.
Well, there's another drop pass. I guess you're kicking a field goal now.
I think that was a bit poorly thrown, though, because of
the pressure.
Yeah.
Well, I noticed that you had a chance maybe to throw the slant on the left side to whoever that was running that over there. Because they only had one safety in the middle of the field, right? But I don't know if you would have had time anyway.
Well, I just missed the... Yeah.
Comes up empty. Wow.
It's first and ten.
Yeah, didn't that drive start as a result of a turnover?
Yes, it did.
See? It's just the conspiracy about, you know, not being able to score on turnovers.
Yeah.
Crosses it right. Big pop that time.
See, what I did here is I did a little bit of a change, and you'll notice that Ostrich has snuck right down number 22. He's snuck right down there.
Yep.
And what I've done is I've basically swapped assignments, and I gave him the man coverage assignment.
And the safety there, the linebacker to deep zone.
Burton here is playing the deep zone.
Yep.
So when I man lock, then he sneaks down to the line to act as an extra run defender.
Yep.
Where Burton is still in a good position to support the run defense. If they do try to run the ball.
Second and nine coming up here.
Base!
Only one man back. Gets the pass off.
Oh, blew the
30. He just
that's our rookie inside linebacker there that blew that.
Perfect pass. Great catch.
He was in man coverage on that guy too, so.
Well, you know how it goes. You know, a smart linebacker is more valuable than a speedy one.
Yep.
It's first and ten.
Well, that's just a little inexperience on his part.
Shifting some personnel up front. They'll go from the I formation. Carpenter moves in motion. Alford records the stop at the 40-yard line. So that's a gain of about five.
Yeah, if you guys want to run now, then that's okay. Go right ahead.
A little over four to go. Spence with split backs. Throwing. This one falls incomplete. They dropped additional people into the secondary, but still generated an excellent pass rush.
And that gives you a lot of flexibility calling
almost
your defense.
Almost got him that time.
The guys up front are almost good at creating pressure. Then you don't have to blitz as often, giving you the ability to double cover an opponent's best receiver.
Dropping back, throws it.
Oh, you beat your guy, and then you had to beat your guy again.
Short pass off the mark, and it's now
don't you hate that when you push him backwards and you have to beat him again?
Well, that's okay. He was throwing that to nobody anyway.
He's been on the sideline loosening up, and yep, here he comes for the seventh time. Here's the punt. Fair catch.
Yep, they should have given you a play in your playbook that called fair catch middle.
First and
That way you could just call that play and then your returner would just go out there and call for a fair catch without you having to actually do anything, right?
Blue, 58. Here we come.
Hudson comes in motion. Hand it off to the back. Big pop that time.
Boom. Now that is big time football.
Pickup of about 7.
Yeah. I like the single back big formation.
Coming up here.
Very versatile. You can pass out of it. You can run out of it. Set. Do lots of stuff with it.
Houston, the motion man. White. He can't wrap him up.
Okay.
Ooh, that's going to leave a mark.
He got hit so hard, he darn near had to take a taxi back to the stadium.
It's first and
ten. Quite often in situations like that, that stretch run will turn into an off-tackle run instead because he'll get a... an opening like right an about there to run through, right?
Number 6, with a man in motion. With a run once again.
Ugh, I just couldn't cut up that hole. That linebacker, like, warped onto me.
Before he could get to the line of scrimmage.
They have great size and quickness up front. That allows them to hold up against the run while also giving them the speed to rush the passer when they drop back to pass.
Looks like he's changing the play.
Short bank! Short bank!
Looking for room. Breaking free. Wright makes the tackle at the 47-yard line.
Sometimes you can be a little over-aggressive on defense like you see here.
That's a cornerback trying to tackle a fullback, too. I mean,
he got caught out of position.
That, you would expect that to happen from time to time.
Yeah. Well, Green there was the tight end that we traded for. He was supposed to be our new star rookie tight end, and I'm just like, nah, he's going to play fullback.
Yeah, well, you still got two good tight ends, so he'll never see the fields until Hudson retires, right?
Drops back.
As a tight end, anyway.
The pass off, and it's complete. Nalen makes the tackle.
But in a two fullback set, he'll get lots of work.
It's first and ten. He sees something in the defense. Hands off to the fullback. Smith with the tackle at the 35-yard line. Ball on the 35-yard line.
Set. Come on now. Back to play. Here that comes.
Yeah, you're just working the clock down now. I don't think they're even going to bother calling timeouts now because I think they're far enough behind.
Oh,
it isn't going to matter.
White couldn't even get out of the backfield.
This defense is extremely active and effective up front.
That would have been huge if I could have just gotten out of the backfield there.
Creating havoc in the backfield.
Just blows chunks.
Plays and draws can be a good way to use their speed and aggressiveness against them.
Well, you can almost run the clock out here.
Come on, let's go. Mike cover! Mike cover!
And he'll get the call. The 30, right.
Oh, look at that. It makes the first down. Well, you don't have to run another play now.
And they're frustrating this defense in the process. Two times they've converted on third
down. So there you go. See? Like I said, that was all they were going to get. That's all they got.
Well, and you know what? Bad things happen when you go to the air.
Yeah, because that's one thing I noticed, too, is as soon as I started playing five-man line, they started passing more, right? But that's the trick, though, is that I can actually make reasonably functional pass defenses out of that formation, too. And so, we're 1 week closer to the end of the season.
On behalf of EA Sports, John Madden and Jill Arrington.
I'm going to have a trash quarterback rating.
Well, you had a couple of miscues in this one, but you also did rack up 49 points. Really bad kick. Oh, my. Well, held them to less than 100 yards both on the ground and through the air.
Nice.
And you managed almost 200 yards rushing and 350 yards passing, in spite of throwing an interception. So, a 94 passer rating, which is okay.
Yeah, I guess it wasn't as bad as I thought.
You completed 65% of your passes. You had a 47-yard pass for a touchdown.
Oh, yeah. See, that's what saved me. I completely forgot about that touchdown pass already.
So, Gaines had a decent rush per average. White had a decent rush average. Roberts had a pretty good day. You were kind of running by committee today.
Oh, well.
Lots of rushing touchdowns, though.
No, we always have a lot.
Six rushing touchdowns.
On some of those, too, though, like I threw a pass and then the guy would get tackled on the one or something like that, right?
Yeah, look at Quincy White with four broken tackles.
See, if he can develop his tackle breaking, then he could be back number one next year.
But Gaines had the long run.
Mm-hmm.
And Hudson had a big day, catching nine passes for 117 yards.
Well, the thing about Gaines, though, too, is he can run people over more consistently, even if he doesn't necessarily get all of the broken tackles. Like, I think some of Quincy White's broken tackles, too, were just, like, bad pursuit angles, too.
Yeah, could be. Anyway, here we go. Sandman 99 with seven tackles and interception.
Three tackles for a loss.
Yep. And Holt got shut out in the sacks today. Alfred Lewis got the only sack.
Yeah, and it was a right end sack.
Yep.
Go figure.
But Hanks, the thing is, though, he wasn't taking sacks, but he did throw two interceptions.
Yep, he was throwing the ball away a lot.
Yep. Oh, got forced fumble by Tarek Kramer.
See, they're like, you got sacked too much last game. So when we play them again this game, I want you to throw that ball no matter what.
Yeah, 0-for-2 kicking field goals. Wow.
Yeah, we had a bad day kicking field goals.
Yeah, you did. Had a bad day kicking field goals.
Benson showed up to work with a hangover.
That being said, his passer rating was 15.1. So he was 9 of 23 with two interceptions.
Wow,
so
they threw a lot of passes.
I held them to, they didn't throw a lot of passes, but I did hold them to 39% completions on the passes they did throw.
They threw a lot of passes. They threw more than they ran.
Yeah, they threw twice as many passes as they ran the ball, or more than twice as many. Yeah, well, 23 passes.
I think what it is they just didn't have the ball.
And 15 rushing attempts, so they did. It wasn't that bad, actually.
Well, 23 attempts and completions. Yeah. I mean, you did sack them once, right?
You got to realize, too, they didn't run very many offensive plays because you had the ball almost the whole game.
That's the goal, though. You can't have an offense if you don't have the ball.
You had that one 47-yard run that really annoyed me. But other than that, they didn't really get very much. Yeah. And you got sacked once by that left outside linebacker. And picked off by the middle linebacker.
Yep.
But anyway, it looks like we're getting tuned up. Oh, look at that. I made player of the game with my...
Nice.
Interception, and I recovered the fumble on the kickoff coverage, too.
Well, I guess that'll do it for this time.
Yeah, we still have the Pigeons number.
Yeah, well, that's because they suck.
Yeah. Anyway.
I'm Rick V5.
And I'm Sandman99.
Have a good one.
Until next time.